Hello and welcome back to Skyward Sword, and we're going to be progressing to finding the next location of the so-called Pharaoh's Flame, as it would be. Where we're going to want to go is actually into the water here and use our newly found dragon scale to progress into the stump of this tree if Link would move. If that happens to you, just like go away and recreate yourself. As you're probably noticing, Link does have an oxygen meter, and the more that you spin, the more it goes down. As you can see, mine is pretty critical right now. If you don't spin, however, it doesn't go down as fast. If you collect an air bubble, then you can just slowly make your way up here, or you can spin if you're feeling confident, however. Right now, I'm kind of getting used to the swimming controls in this game again. They're very different to most swimming controls in video games. Mainly because it involves the motion controller. In this area, there's, like, I think one chest that we need to get, and, well, we don't need to get it, but I'm going to get it because it's a 300 rupee chest. It's probably one of the most necessary things, I would say, if you're really hunting for rupees, which, to be honest, we kind of are hunting for rupees. Like, we began to realize how much money is required in this game when it comes to buying some of the more expensive items, like even beetle pouches and stuff like that. You know, like the beetle inventory items, the adventure pouch upgrades, they cost like 600 for the second one and then 1200 for the one after that, I believe. So, we do need the rupees. If you swing back and forth on this thing by using the gust bellows, we should be able to get enough momentum to go ahead and go for this platform here. I'm not sure if that's enough, I don't think it is. You have to kind of get the maximum amount of push out of gust bellows and then quickly turn around, I feel. From here. I feel quite lucky that I even made that. Okay, from here, you want to head around this side, climb up here, and then walk over here in front of this edge. And then when you turn left, when you get to the top of this, once all these bats are taken care of, you'll notice that there's this little alcove that you can go in, this little tunnel, as it were. And there's a monster claw, actually, I want to pick this up. Considering we never actually seem to get enough of these things. I just realized, does it have like a remnant of like skin or flesh at the end of it? Because that's quite disgusting, it actually looks quite bloody. And you can come up here and take out a bomb. And you can throw it at this Quattro Baba. And I actually found this out like by chance because I thought, how am I going to deal with this thing? And you kill it in one go with that bomb because it eats the bomb. So you can actually just really easily get this chest. There's really no excuse for not getting it. It's 300 rupees. It's a lot of money. So, definitely get that if you didn't know it was there already. It'll probably help you if you're really struggling for money later in the game and you didn't pick it up or something. So you need to dive down here. You could have probably walked down, but I was being a little bit too impatient. And you can go back up to the top and work your way to the exit. No. The exit is obviously that door on the other side. You can deal with this guy, ironically, also with a bomb. However, you can't blow him up. He's just gonna go a little bit crazy if you throw it on top of this platform. And he should, like that, run off. That's how he got rid of him the last time, too. That's only a 1 rupee, don't let it fool you. There's no point in going over there for it. It's just a green. We've already got 1,016 rupees anyway. There's no point in going after one single rupee. It sounded a little bit greedy, but hey, we've already got like over 1,000 rupees. I think we've got enough money to. I think we're getting close to filling our wallet actually. I think your wallet can only hold 1,100 right now, which means we're gonna have to do some gratitude crystals to get another wallet upgrade soon. Unless you want to buy another 300 pouch from Beetle. But I believe you can only get 900 is the maximum additional amount of money you can carry. I'm not really too sure, but you can make it over here and come out of the store. I don't think I've even maxed out my wallet in my own fail yet. I think I've got the wallet after the one we're gonna get soon, and that's it. So, yeah, there's another additional upgrade after the one we're gonna get. So how much money do you need in this game, really? But this is probably one of the Zelda games other than Wind Waker, where you're gonna notice that you need quite a lot of money to even really 100% the game. Wind Waker, you needed a lot of money for maps. And in this game, you need a lot of money for upgrades, items, potion upgrades, shield upgrades, inventory storage upgrades too, like the adventure pouch. You need, I'm trying to think what else you need, medals and stuff like that. Like, you're obviously gonna have to buy the heart medal from Beetle at one point. And I think there's other stuff too. I'm trying to think though. Nothing's coming to mind, but I'm pretty sure there's other things as well. Take that last one out because I feel like it would be a problem. So now I can climb up these things here, and if you just kind of notice what you're doing with these things, you'll notice that it's just going to be more of a stamina thing. I actually noticed a beehive, and I want to be able to take that down because beehives actually count as one of the spoils from enemies that you can gather up, like one of the collectible items, and it will count towards some of your upgrades. And if you want to upgrade your weapons fully towards the end of the game, then you're going to need some of these beehives. Dealing with bees are really annoying, especially after you collect their spoil, but you can deal with them just by swinging your sword around and eventually it'll go away. Probably don't have to flail the sword around as much as I do, but you can just kind of spin it and do enough swipes, and eventually, hey look, he disappeared. Now we can go ahead and climb up these bangs and not really get bothered by them, because if you took this top route here, you would have got attacked by the bees, I believe. I think they would have came after you. Down a bit more. Then you creep over. Climb up to the top. Drop here and go ahead and come in here. Now in here we're going to encounter our first moblin. This is actually a moblin, like this big fat guy here is definitely a moblin. And you can take out a shield, and this one particular moblin has the tendency to push you off the edge just because there is a very, very thin walkway. And you can't really get a stab in him unless you get rid of a shield like that. But the moment the shield's gone, you can go ahead and strike him like crazy. Just be careful, because I can never really tell the range of his weapons. And be careful of you dodging the weapon because of the fact you'll fall off the edge if you're unaware of the ground around you. I'm not having the best of luck here displaying how to deal with this guy, but the moment the shield's gone, you can attack him like crazy. Just wait until he fall. Oh my god, are you kidding me? I'll be right back. You actually need to climb all the way up there if you... I can't believe that happened. So, I think I'm just gonna make sure that I get that across clear. If you get knocked down there, you gotta climb all the way back up the tree again. And it's ridiculous. It is probably one of the most tedious things ever. But it doesn't really matter. I mean, as long as you get up here and save, then there's no way to really get knocked down again. Because you've activated the bird statue, which means you can fly to the area to descend on the world again. Come on. Okay, they're out of the way now. More bats. You know, they're out in the daytime. This really doesn't make any sense to me. I thought the bats were flying to light. Yeah, so they're all dead. And if we look over here, we can notice that this looks out in a viewpoint. We're pretty high up now. There's not a lot around us other than the goddess cube to the right of us. And there's one beneath us also. There's two technically beneath us. I actually saw that. The draw distance was really bad there. There's two. There's one there and there's one there. The one that we can't get is the one further away. And the one that we can is closer to us. Because you have to drop from here to be able to get the one that's closest to us. However, we're going to display that in a couple of minutes. I don't think I can reach him from here. I'm not really sure how I'm gonna go about getting you off of here, but oh well. Maybe if I attack him with a wall or something. Okay, so take your swing shot out and attack the Kikui. And you'll wake up. So once you're done with that little cutscene there, you can come down here and you can notice this little cube that I pointed out earlier. The only way to get to this is by hanging off the ledge. So find a suitable place to hang. Personally, I've seen people do the jump from here, and I'm like, I don't think the jump is a very wise idea. Because if you do the jump, then you're gonna have to kind of, like, for example, look, you're gonna have to position yourself in such a way that you would need to, look at this, like, beneath us. How would you, like, line yourself up to do this? This is a much easier way. I don't understand why people do the jump at all. So you land here, and then just do the tightrope across here. And once we make it across here, you can draw your sword and do the Skyward Strike like we always do. And that will activate another Goddess Cube for us. And I believe that one goes to Thunderhead, which kind of sucks because I like being able to get him conveniently in Skyloft. Okay, so now, like, that target up there basically indicates why we can't get up there. But it doesn't matter for now because there's nothing really that I can do about that. And many who have played the Zelda series before know what that target means and why I can't get up there right now, and because I don't have that particular item. So Fi will basically say, this is the symbol. I am 80% correct because I am a robot, and I have a calculator built into my body and system and whatever. Anyway, it doesn't matter. And we can take our beacon off if the Wiimote wants to be nice, there we go. And head all the way to the gate now, because we know what the symbol is supposed to look like. So now we can do a little skyward beam thing and then draw on the door what the symbol has to look like, which is the objective here. I'm not really sure how to get back to the particular area that I'm looking for. I think up this way is the quickest way to get there. I'm not 100% sure on this, but I believe that this area, or this direction, is where you want to be heading. Okay, so this is where the bats were earlier. I'm just gonna kill them again. I believe they didn't drop a monster claw, did they? Oh, they did. That's nice of them. So that's free for a little collection. Another one. Grass out the rock in the corner, no point going after him. Took heart damage from you as well. That kinda sucks. Maybe I'll find a heart in this bush. Nope, no luck. Okay. So, those little blobs are actually called choo-choos in this game. Somebody really early on corrected me and said that they actually have the Zelda 1 name for choo-choos, which was gels, and I've kind of followed that ever since. I've never identified them, but I believe they are called choo-choos in this game. Maybe at a later point I'll just make sure that I'm correct, and damn bird. And go ahead and identify them. The reason I was trying to catch that bird was because of the fact that that's the only way to get blue feathers in this game, I believe. So you need to go ahead and catch birds in this game to get one of the items. Well, not blue feathers, but bird feathers, I believe. Because we already have some blue feathers. So yeah, just draw like an orb or an egg shape here, and then eventually that'll happen. And now we've proven ourselves worthy to the goddess, which means the door will open. Well, not the goddess, but the water dragon, I guess, because it's her door. So we're going in the right direction now. I know what's on everybody's minds right now. A water area. Great, that means a water temple. The temple for this area isn't very watery, to be honest. There's a couple of areas, yeah, that you gotta deal with water, but it's a very mixed temple. And I'm not just saying that to like make everybody go, well, the temple might not be that bad. It's actually really not that bad of a temple. There are far worse quote-unquote water temples in the Zelda history. Two of which that are known to be very, very bad are, I think Ocarina of Time's one is, well, I know Ocarina of Time's one is the most renowned to be most difficult. I don't agree with that personally. I find Twilight Princess's one way more annoying, but many people don't like Great Bay either. I personally just think that water temples in itself, regardless of the game, regardless of it being Zelda, or like just water levels in general, are very like underappreciated. I don't particularly mind most of them. In fact, I'm gonna be the absolute weird person in here and say that the water temple in Ocarina of Time is an absolute joke in comparison to the one in Twilight Princess, I feel. If you do a spin attack here with your nunchuck, you'll break this. Thank you.
Okay, so now we can continue by following him. Anyway, I don't really think that the Ocarina of Time War Temple is really that bad. The Twilight Princess one, I feel, is a lot worse than the Ocarina of Time one in terms of difficulty. I guess it's just because of the fact that the amount of times you need to switch that damn staircase in Twilight Princess pissed me off. Excuse my French, but it really did. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to come down here and you want to spin attack this fish into that rock and he'll blow up. And you can do it for every rock in this vicinity. And this little dude here, what's hiding? There's actually quite a lot of rocks in this area you may want to deal with. I'm going to try and get all of them before we leave this little area here. If you run out of air and can't get a bubble, you can always go to the surface. Cleared that one out. You can get attacked, though. Just be aware of that by the puffer fish. You can, if you've noticed this already, you can't, like, use Bai underwater. You can't get her to talk to you. I find that kind of weird, to be honest. Why can't Bai talk to me when I'm under the water? Navi could. So could Tattle, and so could Midna, I believe. I'm not sure about Midna. Maybe she could. Okay, so there's this rock here, which I'm gonna have to blow up somehow. I have to deal with this somehow. Hopefully one of these fish will attack me and it'll line up correctly or something. I can't. Let's see. Amber relics, two of them. Might as well gather them up just because of the fact that they're collectibles and we probably will need them at some point to upgrade some item. Blow that up and then come in here and get a rupee. Just watch out for the fish. Okay, so once you talk to him and he's like, you can't make it over here, what you gotta do is you're gonna back off a bit and then turn around and come up to the surface again and then do a spin and go right over. Okay, so now what you can do is come over here and head up on top of this little gap. When you get up here, don't jump off just yet, because what you're going to need to do is, well, if you want to get up, you're going to have to wait to do this anyway, so you're going to have to come up here, attack this two, attack all of these two, so kill them off, progress forward, and there's a goddess cube here, and what you're going to want to do is attack it, make it go up into the sky like we always do, and that's another chest unlocked. I haven't actually been up there to find where that one goes yet, but I'm gonna assume it's somewhere worthwhile. I believe there's actually a chest in here too, for something. And there's also this bird statue here. And I guess by using it, we activate it so we can fly in here now, I hope? Because we could fly out of here if we wanted to there. Okay, so another jelly blob. Open this chest here and hopefully it's something worthwhile. Oh my god, a goddess bloom. I'm not sure if this is always a goddess bloom, but that's my second one. Like, first one on camera, second one collecting them. So that's pretty ridiculous. I'm not sure how rare that is to have two goddess plumes, you know, this early in the game, but I don't know. Goddess plumes are very, very, very rare. I feel bad for you. No, I don't want to talk to you again. Okay, so where did the other one go? I'm probably going to have another derp moment for a second. There isn't a way out of here from up here, is there? Nope. Okay. Weird. I don't know what I'm thinking. Nothing I can do to get up there anyway, that seemed way too high. If that's where I came out earlier, I'm really confused. What am I doing? Yeah, that is where I came out. So, where's the exit? Dirty more? Oh, it's down here! Oh, even looked in here! Oh my god, what am I doing? Well, that wasn't that big of a deal. I mean, it only took me like about a second to figure out that I was just herping and derping my way through this little area. Hopefully that won't ever happen again. Yeah, so everybody makes mistakes, basically, but whatever. You can do a spin attack to get over the top of here. If we can line ourselves up correctly, that'd be great too. There we go. Yep, there. Cleared it. Okay, so this guy isn't even a big problem. In fact, he's pathetic. But this guy, he's terrified of him, so I don't know, we gotta go over there and deal with him, but it shouldn't be that hard. Swim over here, he'll turn red, spin attack him again, and he'll die. So now he's praising us for being the hero's chosen, the goddess's chosen hero, rather. Well, I can't break it with my sword. Oh. Damn. That's what you get for being a Zelda vet in one of these games. It's like, the moment you go to throw something with the A button, it's just like, oh, I need to use the Wiimote now. I don't know. I'm used to just pushing the A button to see Link do the animation of throwing something instead of having to perform the movement myself still. I mean, I did it again. It's just a like, bad habit, I guess. Five. Oh, my money's full. I just realized that we're actually full on money. There's nothing more we can carry. Vi didn't even tell me. I guess she only tells you once. So now you can go ahead and swim around here. You can have a look around if you want. I don't think there's much here in like in the underwater segment other than the Amber Relic, obviously. I don't see anything worthwhile anyway. I'm probably missing out something really daringly obvious, but I don't see anything. So here we are in front of the War Dragon. If you speak to her. I think around here there's nothing but chests that we need to find. I don't think there's any cubes that we need to get in this area. At least that none that I know of anyway. Just gotta keep looking around here. Yes, a couple of chests and an amber rock. I've already collected a few in this video. Why am I getting a prompt for another? Whatever. So if you come here, get a monster horn, probably randomly generated too, and that's our fourth one. On the other side of the room, however, there is another chest, and we're gonna have to go over there and swim to it, because I don't believe there's another way to get up there, other than swimming to it. Could be wrong, but I don't think there's a level that I can really not get right up here instantly. There we go. There's actually that little gap there where I could just do a spin attack and launch myself up if I did it correctly. I think I ate myself a bit too low. Can I just walk around here, actually? That would be very convenient if I could. Number 5. I think in this one, actually, is nothing but money. I think it might be 100 rupees, but I'll go ahead and check just to make sure. My wallet's full, but it's not really that big of a problem if it's only 100, because 100 I can grind really easily. I'd be really annoyed if it was 300. It is 100. Make sure you have room in your wallet, because this game is not forgiving like Twilight Princess, and will take your money away, and you won't be able to ever come back and get it out of that chest. So, be aware of that. Make sure you do your upgrades before you come into the lake, because there is a lot of money to be found here. Yeah, we can only carry up to 1100, which kinda sucks. So I think I'm gonna end the video here, so thanks for watching, and see you guys next time when we continue looking for the flame. Thanks for watching, and goodbye!